Today marks the day. 8,000 hours, I'm getting close. Wow, time really is escaping me. I'm starting to get gray hair now, I'm feeling old. Nowhere near a master of my craft, but every day I feel a little bit closer. Traveling this world has been very entertaining, but man, it feels good to be in the lab. Subject number 01, Trevor Dunbar, the ship team general. A highlight machine, to say the least. Clever ball handler, dime dropper. It's been a few years since we've experimented in the lab. A lot of unfinished business. The subject has a number of glaring deficiencies. Wanted a few to stand out very drastically. His ability to shoot the ball. Not his only dilemma, but it's the most apparent. For so long, his other gifts shielded his inabilities, but he's at the level now where that's no longer possible. As fond as I am of the kid, as much as I want him to succeed, he's not even relatively close. But his work ethic is what makes this all possible. So that's the part where I come in. I've had plenty of experience teaching players how to shoot. Each process was different, and there's no absolutes. About a 74% success rate, the most valuable teacher has been film. And in these few months, I've grasped that film doesn't lie. Pictures rarely do. So I'm going to take this and use this to my advantage, because I'm going to break it down to a science.
Being a shit team general at Washington State didn't mean anything, you know, like that flashy identity, that mixtape identity, it kinda hurt me in a way, because I'll be in practice, throw a turnover, I'll throw a no-look pass. The coaches think it's cause I'm trying to be flashy, I'm trying to look good, you know. I don't really know I'm trying to do misdirection, not telegraph my passes, but like, or I do a three-piece instead of just one move and go past them. You're dribbling too much, but really. Is that's all I know, like that's my game. Me throwing those no-look passes in high school, now I'm playing in college against longer players or just as quick as me, the reaction time, they seen all that, you know what I mean? So like, it was a lot harder. So that whole image I had, it didn't really follow me in a good way. I had a little bit of conflict too. I was getting a little bit of a few fights and stuff like that, and you know, a little scuffle I had. We was scrimmaging. Somebody said off ball screen on me. Big Jordan, he said off ball screen on me, and I was like, yeah, let me just go under the flare. And he was like, nah, like I'm gonna set the screen. I'm gonna get nigh open. So he grabbed me, and I couldn't get out of it. I could get out of it. So I stuck him in the stomach real quick and kept it moving. Nah, he gets the ball. He comes and set a screen on me. Hits me with a cold bow. Yeah, I turn around, hit him with a cold left hook, and then that was that. They came and broke it up. But me and Jordan, we good. Me and Jordan, great. Shout out to Jordan. The biggest lesson was the lessons off the court, discipline off the court, time management, and little stuff like that. That was stopping me from getting the minutes that I wanted. There was games where I didn't even get in. There was games where I played 20 minutes, 25 minutes, but then there's games. Consecutive games where I wouldn't get in, and like there's a point in the season where I kind of just tapped out. It was like I wouldn't be preparing mentally for a game because I knew I wasn't getting in, and that's sad. Like I kind of lost my love for the game. Yeah, at the end of the year, each player goes through a meeting with the coaches, and they ask how the season goes, and I was honest. I just gave them it wasn't a good season for me. Like I said, I had a lot of problems off the court. Being late to class, stuff like that. It was just causing me to you know, getting a hole in the doghouse with the coaches. So it was stopping me from getting those minutes I wanted. And then they said, like all the problems I was having this year, they told me that straight up. They said, you're probably gonna get the same amount of minutes you got this year, next year. Transferring was like, that was like the only option for me. Stuff was distracting me. And that was my biggest problem. And then it was all on me, you know. And it could have been a good year, but it wasn't.
The Pac-12. Mentally, he wasn't ready for that level yet. Can he play right now at some Division I's? Of course he can. But he needs to develop. College basketball is a game of chess, on and off the court. You don't play the game, you think it. The higher you go up, basketball can be a life-changing experience, a joyful one or a depressing one. Just from hanging with Trev, I know that he's not that same Trevor that I met. Hard times lie ahead, but he needs to get back to, yes, playing well, but more having fun. Maturing, but being that goofy kid I met a long time ago.
People be saying that, be like, hey, I seen somebody, the first thing he said, he was like, you the realest dude I know. I was like, why? They said, you check Kyrie Irving. Like, I said, nah, all I said was, because he said to me, he's like, it's cool if I'm in shit team, like, I support. Like, I'm a fan, like, da-da-da, like mess, saying he messed with me, and then he's like, and I was like, yeah, of course, like, you been a shit team, and he's like, yeah, I just had to make sure I check with the captain himself. I'm like, nah, I'm the gen.
I started screaming when I read that.
Subject number 01, first workout, the date, September 3rd, 2015.
The subject has had his difficulties with shooting the ball, complications with his balance, with his release point, arc, and it always changes. Stance looks to be a little bit off, jump to his right, ball comes off his middle finger, his rotation isn't bad though. Past research has shown that he's attempted so many different shots. One motion, two motion, either one can work, both are effective. But the problem is, he's never stuck with one. You can identify that in his mixtapes. I'm comfortable with one motion, but I think I'll go for two motion instead. Today, Trevor is 19, turning 20 years old soon. I'm curious to see how possible it is to reconstruct his shot at this point in his career. I'm guessing it'll take a little over 25 one-on-one sessions to see his progress, but the season is around the corner, which means there isn't that much time.
I vlog everything, as I do of some players. Every workout has a focus in the schedule. It's an equation that I'm trying to solve. What may work for one player may not work for Trevor, but there will always be similarities, which is how I develop the checklist.
Chin up, goose neck check. It's above here. Okay. I mean, all your hand in the middle. Balance
is the most important.
That's bad balance.
You want to cock your wrist under the ball. Get your hand under the ball.
He doesn't really have it yet. He still has to think about it in his head. The more workouts that we build up over time, the more all this will come second nature to him.
Day 11. It's going as planned. It's improving every day. Each session, his percentages are going up. His pull-up, it's a lot better than his three-point shot. But it's because he changes the form. Whether it be unconscious or on purpose, I haven't figured it out yet. But trust is a big part of this process. I have to trust that he will stick with it and shoot the same way every time instead of going off of what he wants to do. And he has to trust me that I will make him a shooter. Which I don't 100% trust him, and he doesn't 100% trust me. But it's okay. Trust doesn't happen this fast, and nor did his progress this far. He didn't come out the womb dribbling the way he does. It was the lab work that got him to where he's at. Players go backwards before they go forward,
we're trying to change something. But maybe Dunbar is different. Game coming up tomorrow, and I will be there. Camera in hand. Them how to shoot the ball. It's not the only reason why I'm training the subject. It's more about completing this game, filling in the gaps, if I might add. This sport isn't a selfish one. It's a team sport that should be built on camaraderie. I want the subject to sacrifice himself for the team. If you're not used to doing that, it's not easy. But he's special in a way where his style of play brings people together. The crowd gets excited. Sometimes even the other team does. It's very peculiar. I want him to focus those abilities on his team. Bring individuals together through excitement. It's easy when things are going well, but what'll happen when controversy strikes? I really enjoy working with Trev, but he challenges me. Without question, it's very hard to teach him how to shoot the ball. One day he has it, the next day he goes away from it. I have a vision that Trev can't see as clearly as me right now.
My shot, I wanted to go in, so if I'm missing when I jump, I know you said trust you, but I'm shooting the same way.
No. You're changing it up. It's on film. I can definitely show you what you're doing wrong.
All right.
Every shot that's going off, almost pretty much, I can show you why it's going off.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So I need you to trust me and jump up on balance. Run yourself down the checklist. If you're saying something, you should be doing it in your head. Be on balance. Feet under me. Not jumping hella far forward. Elbow up every time. Fingers pointed at the rim or down. Whatever. All right.
You're right.
So if you say it in your head, you won't do it. But you need to run your, anytime your shot goes off, run yourself down the checklist. Because we know, we've seen it, that when you shoot the ball correctly, your shot looks good. It's legit, you know? So I need you to stay on track. 50, 59.
I went to LA a few months back. I was experimenting. The idea was to take a group of kids and teach them how to play as a team. It's when I started to log everything. It came at a crucial time in my personal growth.
I've taken an interest into the Golden State Warriors, studying every possession, every play. I don't know if they'll win the championship. I really can't see them beating Cleveland, but I wouldn't be surprised if they did. The way they share the ball, move without it, and get along as a team is amazing. So over the last few weeks, I've applied it to my training. The more that Cornell, Chuck, and myself push ball movement to these guys, the better they get at it. Limiting three dribbles, encouraging help side, working on form shooting, balance shooting. Whether they can shoot or not, more shots are falling because they're open. They seem to be searching for the best shot literally every possession, and the shooter's confidence skyrockets unconsciously because he knows the open shot is what we want, opposed to a contested shot, which is what we don't want. I don't know if I can keep these guys together, but if possible, I think that they could do some really good things.
I wasn't able to keep this group together because of things I couldn't prevent. But my point is, imagine what would happen if Trev caught a hold of that mindset. If he was able to shoot with his ability to pass and dribble, with his speed, his height wouldn't matter. But it's about getting Trev to buy in. He thinks my way of shooting will make him too tired. But I see that he changes things once he gets tired and needs to be in better shape. I love and hate that we bump heads. I really don't care who knows about it. It makes our journey together a lot more fun.
You got to think about it. For whatever you did up to this point, you're right here where you're at.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So there's something that you need to fix. Regardless of all the successes you've had, you made a Division I, whatever, but there's a reason why you're here. Most of it has to do with your jumper. Yeah. You're a solid defender. You're great ball handler. You can pass the ball. If you could fix this, like, that's the next level. So when you get a bad habit, don't go back to what got you here.
Yeah.
That makes sense?
Right.
Someone with good intentions comes up to you and says two words. Good game. I hate moral victories. I want results. But you know what? Life is about how we bounce back up when we get knocked down. What Trev is going through right now is common. So many players can relate to it. And let's be honest. That feeling you get in the pit of your stomach to the core of you. After you put in all those hours of work in the lab, you hit shot after shot in workouts and practice. And you get in the game and none of it pays off. How are you supposed to keep your confidence up? How can you not think about what others think about you? Then you begin to doubt yourself and what you're capable of. It feels like you're so close, yet so far away. This is a part of the process. This is what happens. It's to be expected because none of us are perfect. We all have weaknesses that we can improve on. But there is nothing worse than being in self-denial. Trev has to learn how to tune all that noise out. Training the mind is easy to do and it's complicated too. It's just like any other skill. It takes time and practice. And in order to do that, you gotta have patience. Man, but it's so easy to quit, right? So much easier just to throw it all away. But hey, you know what people say. Only the strong survive, right?
So I just want you to sit here with your eyes closed and just focus, man. Focus on nothing. But at the end, see if you thought about anything while you're breathing, all right? And normally, what are you thinking about while you're focusing on breathing? You're focused on what?
Breathing.
You're focused on breathing, right? So you want to just focus on that one thing, all right? Just focus on one thing, that's breathing. All right, let me start up now.
What if there was a place you could retreat to? A place where time didn't matter, and it was everything that you wanted it to be. And every time you went to this place, it was exactly how you found it, and exactly how you left it. How much did you stretch when you went back to the real world? My guess is that you wouldn't. There needs to be a time in the day where you can get away, where no one else can find you. It's a world that you create in your own mind. Pray, meditate, breathe. Something that pulls us away from life in a way. Trev lives under all of these pressures, some that he creates in his own mind and the expectations that the world creates for him. He doesn't want to let down his fans, let his family down, afraid to damage his image, their negative thoughts. But it's time for him to stop worrying and start living.
Birds.
Thought about the birds?
That was it.
That was it?
That was black.
That was it?
Yeah.
Focus on the breathing and the health. Just focusing on that. Mm-hmm. If you could just become consistent with what you do, you'll turn into a different person. You know, you make habit, you become a creature of habit. Mm-hmm. If everything's kind of like random and spontaneous, that's how you're going to live your life. That's how you're going to play it. A lot of things, you know, will trickle over because of that. Mm-hmm. And you need to make sure that you start to become a creature of habit. You know, doing the same thing every time, especially when we work on these jumpers. Mm-hmm. It's not helping if you're not going game speed.
Right.
You know, especially if you're going for 30 to 45 minutes. You know what I mean? So just keep that in mind when you approach everything every day. Mm-hmm. And learn and understand that you have to be able to train your mind to the point where you don't even think about it, you just do it.
The other day, Trev and I had a long talk. Maybe it worked, maybe it didn't. But the results of it were interesting. He had a tournament in Fresno. The shot wasn't falling still. In the first few games, he did okay. I was just happy to see the confidence was there. He wound up being the MVP of the tournament, which is great. I'm still expecting ups and downs, but I got a feeling that this next game, he's gonna hit some shots, but not before some lab work. I ordered a new toy that I'm hoping will be beneficial for the both of us.
Right, all the way up.
All connected.
Like right now, each knee is bending at the same time, each leg is coming up at the exact same time.
I like to concentrate on the training alone, not so much the percentages. And this new Wilson allowed me to do that. I thought it'd be good for Trev to see. And at the end of it, the app actually shows that he's shooting a solid percentage. I'm gonna share a secret that's not really a secret. Shooting the ball is probably 50% confidence. How many times have you seen someone come into the gym who was terrible? Terrible form and hit shot after shot while talking trash. And then how many times have you seen the shooter struggle? Most of the time, it's just in their heads. See, after viewing the film, I can tell that Trev doesn't go into the shot knowing that it'll go in. Whether he makes it or misses it, it affects the next shot. His form is inconsistent, yes, but if he were to display the same amount of confidence in the shot as he does in his handle, man, I can only imagine how good he would be. Once we're done battling ourselves in our own mind, tuning out the negative, then it's time to take on the rest of the world.
like results work like instant oatmeal. I just hope Trevor isn't one of those people. But nonetheless, today I saw a kid that was having fun. And today, I saw a very focused team. I'm not gonna sit here and pretend that everything is perfect now. Still gotta get his hand under the ball, bring the elbow in a little. He shot the ball on balance though, and shot it with confidence, which means more than my expectations. Because I'm working with him at the worst possible time during season. But I'm taking a chance though. Will he persevere regardless of the obstacles? Will he learn how to tune out all the noise? Will he stay in the lab? I don't know. I can only hope so. Because I want to keep at it until we get it. My biggest challenge yet that I accept 100%.